During this dive in Cuba, we came across these huge shoals of silversides. They were just concentrated in a particular area. They're literally millions of fish all packed tightly together. And it made quite a lovely scene, actually. They behave a bit like a flock of starlings, you know, the murmuration of starlings. Anything comes into the middle of them, they all separate, make really lovely shapes. And I noticed that this grouper disappeared down into this crack, and I looked down and you can see there was a crack in the rocks. So we hastily repositioned our bait box, which is used to attract the sharks, and then made our way down into the crack. And my idea was to shoot up towards the surface through the shoal of silversides and hopefully see the circling sharks above. So here we are, we're now in the cave, well, cave as such, it's really a slit in the rocks, and looking up. And I love being in confined spaces like this, to be honest. It's really peaceful and it makes you concentrate on everything going on around you. But the grouper had followed me in, and every time he moved through the shoal, there's a shark going over the top now, look. Every time he moved through the shoal, they dispersed in this almost mesmerizing way, really. So I stayed there for a while and I took my shots of the sharks from below, but it quickly became obvious to me it wasn't going to work. The sharks were just too far away. So look, there's a shot. The shark's there, you know it's a shark, but really it's not got the punch that I hoped for. So I stayed there a little bit longer, but the grouper kept coming back and he was interested in me. And here he is, and he's sort of sideways on, and all the silver sides spread look. And I began to think, do you know what? I wonder if actually the shot is of the grouper. So I kept waiting for, there's a shark going over now. I kept waiting for him to come back, hoping that he would at one point turn and face me so that these silver sides would frame him, because it was quite obvious they were making a circle around him. And here he comes back now. He's going to come back from the bottom right of the frame, I think. And I knew when he was coming. Here he comes, look, because I could see them all spreading like a big wave in front of him. So I was at it for about 10 minutes, and I took a variety of shots, but he never, ever turned to face me. This was the best I got. Anyway, we stayed there for another few minutes and then decided it wasn't going to work. So we came out of the little crack in the rocks, came back up, picked up our bait box and swam off to see if we could find something else. So it nearly worked, but not quite. But nevertheless, I'm happy with what I got.